think my first response was just to take off running. So I'm running and praying that he's going to be okay.
For me, there was a lot of emotion at the time, you know. Steve's a friend, first and foremost, but also I have a hand in building the race cars that he drives, so I didn't know how severe it was.
And your heart just drops because I wanted to see him pop out the car. And then once I got halfway there, I was able to slow my run to a jog. I'm like, all right. He jumped out, he put his hands up, he's all good, and I knew that the car did what it was meant to do, and that was break away and absorb that impact. But it's still just one of those moments where it just shocks you and just takes your breath and makes your heart stop.
Within seconds, he starts moving in the car and he gets out, and it's the greatest feeling in the world.
It says a lot about the attention to detail of those MLR race cars, but as I said, I mean, it's just a credit to the rules and the safety, you know, the safety equipment these days as to why that Steve was able to get right out.
Steve told me 17 years ago, Mom, if I die in that race car, I'm happy. It beats the heck out of laying up at Baylor Hospital fighting cancer. So when it's his turn, he's gonna go, no matter what it is. And we have the pleasure and are blessed enough to do this as a family.